Initiates the contraction in, and when overlaid with EMT, the treating, the response to the form of the relaxation of the patient begins. data can be normalized to either the vehicle control or to a time point or to both, giving us a double normalization. This is what the time course looks like for contraction inhibitors using this cardio analysis template. As you can see, anesthetic as well as anti-arrhythmic drug, and we tested also a myosin inhibitor. And what you can see is that both lidocaine and the myosin inhibitor cause an immediate reduction in contraction amplitude. So contraction amplitude is graphed on the left side of each graph and the time point along the bottom of each graph. And with lidocaine, you can see that we just bottom out at all of the concentrations that we tested, and it's immediate in the effect. It's also immediate with the myosin inhibitor, but we were able to generate a good dose response with this. What looking at the time course does for us is it gives us an ability to pick where we generate our dose response. For the myosin inhibitor, the dose response can actually be generated from any one time point. And we can also look at what happens with the contraction after we wash out the drug as well. So this is looking further out into the same study where we washed out the drug at about 41 minutes. And then we continue to assess. And what you can see here is that we have a return of contraction. It starts to recover. This is the dose response curve for the myosin inhibitor. The IC50 that we obtained from these studies is consistent with what we observed in our primary adult myocyte assay. Here we had an IC50 of 9.7 to the minus 8, times 10 to the minus 8. And in all of the compounds that we've tested so far in this particular, all of the inhibitors that we've looked at, our results are consistent with what we see in our primary myosin assay. An overlay of the two waveforms is shown at the bottom. And what you can see here, this is all.
I 113円、ちょうどお預けします。